Amazing. It was a really nice family to get together, and not just family, but we're talking about village. And you know, as we always say, and I always endorse, that it takes a family to raise a child. And I have grown to now respect and believe that now more than ever, because I, as I said to you, I was invited to this birthday bash by a faithful listener, Miss Pamela. I call her Auntie Pamela. And Auntie Pamela is the daughter of a 96-year-old Miss, I call her Miss Dolly. Miss Dolly, her boy. When I tell you Miss Dolly is a sweetbread, Miss Dolly is a lady who, I want to tell you, Trinidad and Tobago, when you think about somebody who really understand what it is to a community to raise a child or the children in our community, Miss Dolly is like that. We wonder why people live so long like Miss Dolly. How come they live so long? What is the strategy? What is their method to this madness called the world and life? And what are they eating and drinking to live so long? You know, we ask that question. We always ask that question. How do people like Miss Dolly live to a ripe old age like that? I have learned the key and the secret. You know what's the secret? The secret is treating people right. Treating people right. You know, I learned this weekend that Miss Dolly is a lady. We'll go to the market. She live in Palo Seco, but let's say she go to Saparia Market. Leave with two bags, but coming back with two children. Because somebody would have said to her, I can't take care of the children and, you know, this and whatever. And Miss Dolly would say, give me them. And she will bring up the children and bring them up in such a fantastic way that they grow up with her. They leave, get married. And if you see those people today, so I was able to meet people who Miss Dolly would have brought up from childhood. That is big man and woman who have grandchildren. And I want to tip my hat off to Miss Dolly. And something I learned over the weekend from being a part of the family. I was adopted into the family now. Eh? And something I learned, and one of the things I learned from that family is that you have to be true to yourself and to your God and to your family. Be true to them. And Miss Dolly, I want to say to you that I pray that you live long until 100 and no much. You know, I pray that you live long. You are living a long, satisfying life. When you see Miss Dolly, you know that she's happy and comfortable, and she's living a satisfied life in God. She loves her Jesus. She loves God. And I enjoyed being a part of the celebration on Saturday. And I know that today is her son's birthday. And I want to wish him happy birthday. And I pray that God will give you long life too, because, you know, I listened to Miss Dolly on Saturday and she had high praises for her son. You know, the Bible talks about that. Honor your mother and your father so that your days will be long in the land of the living. And when you see how she talks about her son, how he honors her and he takes care of her. Yeah, boy, I could understand why they're living so long. They're living so long because of genuine love for one another and people. So again, I want to say to Miss Dolly, thank you very, very much for inviting me on Saturday. I thoroughly enjoyed myself. And to all the persons who would have come up to me, I met a lady who's a silent listener for 8 years. She is a silent listener to the Street 919 FM. And I want to say hello to her also. And thank you very much again, Miss Dolly and family, for inviting me to come and be a part of the celebration on Saturday. And I pray that God will continue to keep the family and keep everybody, you know, under his love and protective care. So, Trinidad and Tobago, it's at 12:25. And again, let me say thank you to all the persons joining me on Facebook and on YouTube. Yeah. A lot of you joining me on Facebook and on YouTube. And I want to say thank you all very much. Thank you all very, very much for joining me on Facebook and on YouTube. So remember, when you come onto Facebook and YouTube, share the live. Share the live to somebody who you know. Because for the month of August, we want to reach 1,000 persons on the Street 919 FM. So we want to have 1,000 persons watching us. Not just 300 and 400, but 1,000 persons. And again, over the weekend, I had the privilege again to meet up with an old friend, Miss Amelia Ranghill, and her mother, Miss Ranghill, who lives in Laramie and George Street. Really, really lovely soul. And I want to say thank you to them also. And she has a daughter here from America. So I want to say thank you to them for having me. So, let me get into the program today. Today, I want to talk to you all. Hey, Kern. All right, Kern is locked on. My good brother, Kern is locked on. And I know that Kern was busy over the weekend because over the weekend, the CPEP and the Ministry of Local Government was busy all over San Fernando cleaning up. So the Minister of Local Government would have cleaned up that old police station. You know, they have a police station in San Fernando that needed cleaning up. So the Minister of Rural Development and Local Government, I should say, would have done some work on the building. Clean up works on the building. I don't know how many of you saw it. If you're from San Fernando, join me on the live. And I just want to show you a picture. Because I saw the minister would have put it up where they were doing some work and they were doing some cleanup in San Fernando. And I just want to show you what it looked like, right? I saw, and I want to say, you know, hats off to him for the building looking good. Yeah, looks good, man. Looks good. And I've seen where some of the councillors and some of the people from San Fernando really coming out and giving high praises to the work that was being done in the community on when it was over the weekend. So come on the live. This is the building here. You see this building here? Come on the live and see this building. So those of you who live in San Fernando, you all would have been aware of this building here. You see this building? It was an eyesore. I seen it. It was an eyesore. Look at how this building was really embarrassing. To me, it was really insulting to San Fernando. And I must say that the local government minister, Mr. Faris Alwari, who is the member of parliament for San Fernando West, over the weekend, they cleaned it up. So come on the live. I wanted to show you the before and after. So this is the building here. Come on live and see the building. Come and see how terrible. horrible this building was looking. Look at it. So those of you joining me on the live again, thank you very much. So this is the building. Most of you from San Fernando would know this building. So this is a building that was, that you know, in San Fernando, and it was terrible, horrible. And I saw where they did something. I want to show you the after. I see before. This is the after here. Well, let's come on in live and see how this building looking now. This is how the building, this is how they clean it up, and this is how it's looking now. Right? Before and after. You seeing it? That is the after. What do you think? Tell me what you think on the chat. Or let's say something on the chat. What do you think? This is the after. So you see the after? That is the after. That is the after. So if you missed the before, I will show you the before now. So let me show you the how it used to look before. This is how it used to look before. Right? This is how it looked, used to look before. Horrible. Terrible. Scary. Being real with you. Now that this was really terrible. But the Minister of Local Government and Rural Affairs, Mr. Faris Alwari, Member of Parliament for San Fernando West, did some work on it. And over the weekend, he cleaned it up. And this is how it's looking now. That's how it's looking. Before and after. Before and after. And I know that they still have some work to do on it. So they're going to continue. I know that he's going to continue whatever work that they're doing on it. But this is, I have to say, thank you very much. Some people are saying, well done, South people, Southern people, good job, well done. All right, so there are some people who are really commending the local government on the work that they did over the weekend. All right, so jump on the live. I have one more to show you. One more to show you really quick, because I want to get into my discussion today and I don't want the time to run out on me. But I want you to jump back on the live. I want to show you one more. One more of what took place in San Fernando over the weekend. So I really wanted to boast about that because I felt it to be necessary that we are aware of what took place over the weekend. I think that was a great job. Well done. Really, really good job. All right. How many of you remember this guy? This guy was on the street 919 FM, and he also was a part of the cleanup job. So come and see this. Watch this here. Let's hear what Councillor for Monreport Navet had to say.
Trinidad and Tobago, good morning. Nigel Coutier, the Councillor for Monreport Navet. We're on day two. We're on day two of the national cleanup. We're in Monreport, we're in the Santos, and guess what? A lot have been done. A lot have been taken place. I want to thank the Minister of Local Government for his great initiative in national cleanup. So yes, there is this cleanup, there is the community clean, there is the work done. Right? All the ball place has been removed. I got a lot more to accomplish for the end of the day. So I want to say a heartfelt thank you for the underground and the connected with the people. Street to street, house to house, Nigel is good for it.
So my member of parliament, you know, my member of parliament with the minister of local government, you know, they were chatting. So now I can't not show a member of parliament in the midst of all of this, eh? You know what I mean? So I'll just show off a little bit now. So let me give you a little taste of my member of parliament, my councillor, and the local government minister, Mr. Faisal Wahbi. So join me on the live.
One of our community developments in Pleasantville, and Minister is really here. This is Pleasantville Hollows, one of four projects that we have in Pleasantville that is similar to us.
Congratulations, Brian Manning, MP, Robert Paris, long-standing councillor, who's worshiping the mayor, feeding our city, creating employment, peaceful place, well done, pillar to post, we support anything that's good.
Reducing food prices.
So that's what I'm talking about. So you see what happened in my community over the weekend? So I'm sharing with you all that happened in my community over the weekend. So there you saw my member of parliament, Mr. Brian Manning, with the mayor of San Fernando and also the minister of local government, Mr. Faris Alwari, and my councillor. And they were talking about a project that has really, how to put it, a really great project that have been endorsed and been have been really, you know, a happy project in my community, which is the Hollows in Pleasantville. And whenever you're in San Fernando and whenever you are around Pleasantville, check out the Hollows. Be a part of it. All right, so this is what I want to talk to you today about. All right, I want to talk to you about something that's in the news, and it is something that is really impactful in the sense that it's a discussion that has been going on, and I wanted to hear your views on it. There are some people wish that it just go away, but it will not go away, because I think that is something up for a lot of discussion. All right, I know that, before I move on, because if I don't show this, I know I'll get a little buff. So let me show this, and then I will move on. I have about 5 minutes to show this. So let me show this, and then I will move on. Because if I don't show this, oh Lord, I ain't going to hear the end of it. So I have one, you see what I'm talking about? So I have one more clip to show. After I show this clip, all right, that's it for me. All right, I have one more clip to show. So I'm going to show this clip, and then after that, I'm going to move into the discussion that I'm having today with you. So again, I just want to reiterate that over the weekend, I really had a great time in Palo Seco with Miss Dolly and her family. I really had a great time, and I want to say thank you all very much for having me and adopting me as a part of the family. All right, I really want to say thank you all very much for adopting me and having me as part of your family. So yes, I want to just show you all to another clip. All right, so join me on the live as I show you this clip. I think this clip will be the creme de la creme, as they would say. All right, the creme de la creme. Right? I want to show you all this clip, and as I show you all this clip, I want you all to, you know what I mean? Watch and see. Oh gosh, this is an old video. Why did this person send me this video? This video must be about how much years old? You're not into the world. All right, so let me show you all this video now. All right, let me show you all this video. So look at this. jump on the live. And I believe that this is coming to a community near you just now, eh? All right? I believe that this is coming to a community near you where, you know, you can look forward to seeing great stuff being done by the Ministry of Local Government. All right, so look at this video. Jump on the live and look at this video, and you all will see some of the work that was done also in my community. So this is two abandoned HDC houses. Look at this. Right? This is two abandoned HDC houses. So those are two abandoned derelict HDC homes that needed cleanup. But I want to show you after the cleanup on Saturday, I want to show you what happened. So over the weekend they would have cleaned it up, and this is how it looks now. Right? So jump on the live and see how it looks now. So I showed you the before, there's the after. See how it looking? See the kind of work these people and them put on over the weekend, boy. So I want to take my hat off to the CPEP gangs. Yeah, boy. CPEP really, really worked hard over the weekend. And I want to say thank you to them. If nobody didn't say thanks, Street 919 FM, Pastor Google, saying thank you for all the hard work that you all did over this weekend. So come on the live and you would see. Come on the live and you'll see. You see how much hard work these people put on over the weekend, right? So I want to say thank you all very much. Continue the hard work, and your work is not in vain. And I am one of the persons who will take my hat off to you guys. So thank you again, thank you, thank you, thank you so much to the CPEP gangs and the Ministry of Local Government, you know, and I'm saying to you, Trinidad and Tobago, look forward to seeing it happen in your community. I am just boasting because it happened in my community, all right? So again, thank you all very, 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 very much. So let me get into the business of what I come here to talk about today. What I came here to talk about today is something that I saw in the news, and I want to highlight it. I want to bring it to your attention. And I know that it's a discussion that is all over Trinidad and Tobago, so I'm not going to move away from it. I'm going to continue with it. And I would want to hear your views on it, Trinidad and Tobago. So if you are not on the live as yet, you need to join me on the live as we get into the discussion here. Which is the Law Association say it is not a party group. The Law Association says they are not a party group. That's one. Two, I want you to listen. I'm just reading out some headlines that that jumped out at me over the weekend. The other headline that jumped out at me over the weekend is this one that I want to play for you also. And it's all about the Scrap Iron Dealers Association. Now, I want to tip my hat off to them, because there were times when they used to really kind of chew my off, eh? But I want to take my hat off to them because, and I want to highlight something. Because there are some people who highlight the good, or there are some people who will not want to point out to you the, how to put it? Because they would have found a solution, or they're trying to find a solution to a situation that is becoming a pandemic. Because they know everything now is a pandemic. It is becoming a real nuisance. And you know there's a saying by Michelangelo, I believe it is. I could be wrong, I could be corrected, I'm not sure. That there are some people who talk about things, there are some people who make things happen, and there are some people who find solution to things. And I want to take my hat off to the Scrap Iron Dealers Association for finding a solution to a problem that is happening in our country. So I want to play for you two things today. The Scrap Iron Dealers Association that is trying to find a solution to an issue that is confronting our nation. And also, I want to deal with the law association and what they're saying. So jump on the live. Look at this. A solution to a problem, because we have a problem with the Scrap Iron deal, the so-called people who come around scrap iron buying, and we're seeing where there are some of them stealing things from people's homes and stealing things from communities. But I want you to watch and see and hear what are some of the solutions that the Scrap Iron Dealers have come up with. And I want to take my hat off to them, and I want to highlight it on my show what they came up with. They found a solution instead of blaming people and asking the government to find a solution for them. They came up with a solution for themselves. Hats off to you guys. Listen to this.
A lot of y'all know that stolen stuff is coming to your yard, and you're still pushing it. You're still pushing it.
This applies to copper and other metals as well. As a result, President of the TNT Scrap Iron Dealers Association, Alan Ferguson, says now more than ever, the industry is at a risk of being shut down and serious decisions had to be made. It is in this vein that TTCDA and the government met on Wednesday to discuss the way forward.
Please, let us work together with the government. Let all of us stand firm and remove this evil from in our industry.
Ferguson says in the coming weeks, several policies seeking to eradicate the theft that is occurring would be rolled out. According to former TTCDA Secretary Kenny Plaza, part of the short-term action plan is for the registration of all scrap iron collectors.
All scrap collectors must be publicly identifiable by the Trinidad and Tobago Scrap Iron Dealers Association sticker. 3. All scrap collectors must present upon to scrap iron dealers, or yards as it's known, a complete van collector's form.
That form would apply to a listing of specific items of interest. It includes WASA, TSTT and TNTech equipment, manhole covers, metal doors, compressors and pumps, and would be a red flag for any collector or dealer.
This will now tell the dealer, was these items obtained legally? And there will be extensive proof needed to prove that it was obtained legally.
The form would reveal the description and quantity of items, the location where the items were collected, the cost to obtain the items, as well as the address and phone contact of the person who the items came from. While the items are in transit, Plaza says they must be available for inspection by the police or the association.
Failure to do so, scrap collectors could be taken into custody and all goods in transit seized for investigation.
All dealers will now be given a registration number by the association to display alongside their license issued by the court. They would have to fill out a form for the specific items of interest containing the details of the collector the items were received from. TTC, the dealers, would be required to hold such items in their custody for 7 days to allow for checks or police investigations. If a theft is detected, the following action must be taken.
The registered TTC dealer must contact the nearest police station, surrender the goods to the authority, and furnish the person, the police service, with all details of the collector.
Plaza says very soon registration would be needed to operate within the industry. He says this also applies to local and foreign exporters.
Everyone needs to be registered with the association as of now. That is our call. And everybody needs to understand that there are regulations coming, that you need to have your license in order.
Sensitization campaigns to inform the public are to come. TTC Dealer is inviting scrap iron stakeholders to a meeting at the association's building in Kelly Village on Saturday. Registration will start then and would be ongoing for a month. Alicia Boucher, TV6 News.
I want to thank Alicia Bouger for that report, and I used it today for edification reasons. So, Trinidad and Tobago, I want to see somebody seeing on the live. Just somebody, I read a message just now on our YouTube page. Somebody saying, is it YouTube or Facebook? I feel I see it on Facebook. Where was it? Shut them down. Too late for this solution. Oh my. I wouldn't say that. I think I wanted to clap, you know, give them a. Came up with a solution to an issue that's happening in their industry. There are not much persons that can do that. Clearly, they didn't talk to the union before they came up with that solution. You know? So again, I want to say hats off to them. And I'm going to continue to follow up on that story. If I could get somebody from the scrap iron dealers to come in the studio and highlight it a little more for us, and we could question them a little bit, and we could find out from them how they're going to tweak it and get it to work properly, I am all for that. So I want to again take my hat off and congratulate the scrap iron dealers for coming up with a solution to an issue in their industry. So my big story for today is the Law Association. Saying they are not a political party, and I just wanted to read out something from what they said. The Law Association says it's not a political party and is calling on the opposition leader to withdraw her statements. All right? To withdraw her statements about attorneys who voted against the two motions against the Attorney General last Friday. The Law Association says it has no issue with citizens, all right, who have no problem, you know. But hear what? They are not a political party. So again, I want to look at this story. I want you to listen to the story. And when we come back from the break, I want you to tell me what is your thoughts about this Law Association story.
On members, In a statement issued on Friday, the Law Association of Trinidad and Tobago, or LATT, responded to what it called an unwarranted attack by the leader of the opposition on members of the Law Association who participated in and voted at its recent special general meeting. That meeting occurred last Friday at the Hyatt Regency Hotel and involved two unsuccessful motions against Attorney General Reginald Amor, who is also a senior counsel. 1 week later, the LATT said that its meetings are private meetings of professionals who make up the membership, and that at the SGM, which the opposition leader said she attended, members were reminded that the meeting was a private one. During the UNC's Monday night forum, opposition leader and senior counsel Kamla Prasad Bisesa did not mince her words about the result of the votes on both motions against the AG.
For me, it was hysterical and hilarious to see these seniors and board appointees lining up one after the other to grovel, One by one, these PNM senior counsels and board members resorted to becoming grovelers and beggars to save their money train from the AG and from the government.
All right, we're going for a break. We're going to come back.
Is it all right if I give you some Caribbean reggae music? Worship this afternoon. So we stand and lift up our hands, hey, for the joy of the Lord is my strength, hey, so we bow down, worship him now, how great, how awesome is, everybody help me say, we say, say, so we stand, give us some music again, please, now. Worship the name of Jesus. Hey, 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 hey. Love, we say. So we stand and lift up our hands. Lift it up, lift it up. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. Yeah, yeah. We bow down and worship him now. How great and awesome is everybody help you say. Yeah,
we
School of Universal Practical Knowledge under Commanding General Yohana will be on the street 91.9 FM every Monday from 7:05 p.m. to 8:00 p.m. p.m. bringing you the truth according to the Bible. The ISUPK is a non-profit faith-based community organization that will respond to the plagues that's affecting blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. We also have programs such as education, both adult and youth, food distribution, rehabilitation, both drug and alcohol, mentoring, counseling, and spiritual support. Remember, tune in every Monday on 91.9 FM, 7:05 p.m. Shalom.
In Trinidad and Tobago, there are so many things to talk about. Social issues, injustice, child abuse, domestic violence, political scandals, and much more. On HODP, we will cover all that and much more. Don't forget, you can catch us every Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday nights from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. on Facebook and Instagram. Hot off the press. Hot topics, no filter.
Every Friday, it's all about Firewood Soca Fridays with MC Duke and Selector Kochi from 6 straight to 9 p.m. Blazing all the latest and past soca hits. So remember, make it a line, make it a day. Rock and come in, you know. It's all about Firemoon Soca Fridays on the Street 919 FM. Don't know.
Good about that, looking like it real bad.
Are you ready for that Pope experience again? The Sea Champion and the Embassy say, book with us for that unforgettable boat ride experience. Sea Champion, leaving from King's Wharf, San Fernando. And the Embassy, leaving from Breakfast Shed, Port of Spain or Westside Trinidad. For more information, call 399-5959, 281-4723. Or email us at coralvisiontt@gmail.com. Book now and reserve your crew.
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's radio. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio
are invited to join Pastors Morris and Agnes Johnson of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly Miracle Center, located at number 399 Eastern Main Road, Guayco, in Sangre Grande, for the Old Time Gospel Hour Family Radio Ministry every Sunday from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. Check out the Children's Hour Worship Ministry of the Word and the Family Forum every Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. The Law and You every Friday evening from 9 a.m. to 5 a.m. All night prayer live on the Street 919 FM, designed with you in mind. This program deals with today's issues from a biblical perspective. You will also be given the opportunity to call in and interact with us. Micah 6:8 says, "He had showeth thee, O main, and what doeth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with thy God." Your financial support through the First Citizens Bank will be greatly appreciated. Account number 795-222. In the name of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly. For further information, call 753-1133 or email us at church668hope@gmail.com.
Share the live.
Share the live.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the live.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the live.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the live.
The Street 919 FM.
right, I'm back with you. It's 4 minutes past the hour of 1 o'clock. If you're supposed to be somewhere for 1 o'clock, you are very late. If you're supposed to be there for 2 o'clock, you have about an hour and something, an hour. So you can make it. Not if you're coming from South, eh? If you're coming from San Fernando, you have to take your time on the nation's roads. Let me say good afternoon to Bishop Mark Nichols, who is listening all the way in London. And you know, there's a hospital in the UK where there is some nurses from Trinidad who is always locked on and listening. They said to me, we listened to Sharon in the, we listened to Sharon Felix, Dominic, Pastor Google, Aisha Wells, always locked on. Well, I told them they have to listen to the VNR show too, you know what I mean? You can't leave out the VNR show, which, you know, would cool down the talk a little bit. Cool down the talk a little bit to jump back into some hot topics with Aisha Wells. So, you know, you have to listen to the VNR. You have to listen to everything on the street, you know. Everything you have to listen to on the street 919 FM. From all the health programs to all the inspirational programs to all the everything. Politics. Everything you have to listen to on the street 919 FM. So I'm going back to the discussion or the topic that I started off before you went for the break. So I wanted to talk to you about, I wanted to hear your views on this issue. Do you think that Ms. Bisessa should apologize? Or I shouldn't say anything, she would not, let me take that back. Do you think that the Law Association, just like how they want a vote of no confidence in the Attorney General, do you think that the Law Association should ask Ms. Bisessa to give back her silk? Give back her silk, right? And pass a motion of no confidence in the attorney in Ms. Bisessa. So listen to the questions, a twofold question. And I want you to stay on topic. I want you to stay on point. And I want you to answer the question as I have asked. So the question I'm asking is, do you think that the Law Association, right, should ask or take back silk? Or who does give the silk? Who does give that? Should be far ask that question. But do you think that Ms. Bisessa should give back her silk? Right? And because the Law Association basically is rebuking Ms. Bisessa, you know, because she has broken the confidentiality policy of the Law Association. So my thing is, if you have broken the confidentiality of the Law Association, then the Law Association should either ask you to move away from the Law Association or have a vote of no confidence in you as opposition leader. Because Ms. Bisessa has proven herself now to be somebody who is not trustworthy. Because she cannot be confidential. If you're saying to me that there's a level of confidentiality that they were looking for or they had set out in the program. So you come to me as a pastor and you say to me, Pastor Google, I want to speak to you about something confidential. And then I come on the radio. And I now refer to your story. And even go as far as to call names of people in the story that you tell me about. Do you think that I should be trustworthy? You know, half of you would say, he ain't no pastor, you know. Because I told him something in confidence. And he go on and blast my business out on the street. I have no confidence in Pastor Google anymore as a pastor because he has lost that reverence. Because you're supposed to be confidential. So if you missed it, because you're hearing all sorts of foolishness, and tonight you will hear it for more. But listen to it again. For those of you who missed it, I'm going to play it for you. Listen to the Law Association and what they said. And I'm going to ask you again, do you think that the Law Association should take a position of asking Ms. Bisessa to give back silk and pass a no confidence motion against her as opposition leader? Listen to the Law Association this afternoon. Listen.
Statement issued on Friday, the Law Association of Trinidad and Tobago, or LATT, responded to what it called an unwarranted attack by the leader of the opposition on members of the Law Association who participated in and voted at its recent special general meeting. That meeting occurred last Friday at the Hyatt Regency Hotel and involved two unsuccessful motions against Attorney General Reginald Amor, who is also a senior counsel. 1 week later, the LATT said that its meetings are private meetings of professionals who make up the membership, and that at the SGM, which the opposition leader said she attended, members were reminded that the meeting was a private one. During the UNC's Monday night forum, opposition leader and senior counsel Kamla Prasad Bisessa did not mince her words about the result of the votes on both motions against the AG.
For me, it was hysterical and hilarious to see these seniors and board appointees lining up one after the other to grovel. One by one, these PNM senior counsels and board members resorted to becoming grovelers and beggars to save their money train from the AG and from the government.
The LATT said members had inquired prior to and at the meeting whether voting was going to be anonymous and by secret ballot, as was the case. The Law Association said the council of the LATT was therefore surprised and disappointed that the leader of the opposition, an attendee, not only made public how certain members had indicated they were going to vote, but singled out certain members for an unseemingly public attack, and in the association's words, attributing the most dishonorable of motives to them for the position they took. At the SGM, there was a vote on a motion of no confidence in Attorney General Amor, which stemmed from a controversy surrounding him and Trinidad and Tobago's representation at the Piako Airport corruption matter in Miami, something that prompted calls from the opposition for him to either resign as AG or for the Prime Minister to fire him from the cabinet. 234 attorneys who attended the special general meeting voted in favor of the motion, but 317 voted against it. There was also a vote on a separate motion which called for Senior Counselor Moore to resign as AG, which saw 241 attorneys present voting for it, but 310 voting against it. As such, both motions failed, and a few hours afterwards, Attorney General Amor issued a statement in which he said he had been humbled by the result. In a statement on Thursday, opposition leader Prasad Bisessa issued a list and said the public has a right to know that attorneys who defended AG Amor at the special meeting, in her words, have all either received large state briefs or sit as chairmen on state boards. The Law Association said what it called the attempt at the public shaming of its respected members by the leader of the opposition could only have a regrettably chilling effect, especially on younger members, of discouraging freedom of expression in future debates. The LATT said it is not a political party, nor are its statutory objectives political ones, and that as such, it calls upon the leader of the opposition to, in its words, do what is appropriate and withdraw her statements. Jewel Brown, TV6 News.
And my good partner, Jewel Brown, man. They thank Jewel for doing that good report Although the other day I was a little upset with him with the one he did with the home, but that's okay. He make up for it with this one. So I'm taking your calls. Now stick with my question. Respond to my question. Don't go all over the place. Right? Stick with the question. Answer the question. You want to know what the question is? Do you think that the law association should either do, should ask or should not? Yeah, ask Miss B. Sessa to give back Silk because of her breach of confidentiality. Number one, number two, and file a motion of no confidence, which some people would say to me, Google, that is an oxymoron, because even if the law association pass a no confidence motion in the opposition leader, it has no consequences, because it has nowhere in our constitution that will really cause any ripple effect. All right, so I understand that. I fully understand that. But in what you think the law association should say, especially with the breach of confidentiality with Ms. B. Sessa? I think, in all honesty, Ms. B. Sessa should not be called by no senior counsel anymore with Silk. No. That's my thing. So I'm going to the calls. I'm taking the call. I tell you how I feel about it already. Because you're really, really, Ms. B. Sessa, you breached confidentiality, which is a big, 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 big thing when it comes down to, and it's not the first time you do it. It's not the first time you did it. All right? So when it comes down to us now respecting you or looking up to you, because if you could breach confidentiality in the law association and in trivial things like, well, not trivial, but in major things like this, you could imagine for little minor or little other things that you might be talking about people, you know what I mean? So, again, that's why I just say, you know, before I take the calls, hello, good afternoon. Before I take the call, that's why I just say all the time, and I'll keep saying it, this is where I have a real issue with spirituality and people who are of the cloth like myself. I believe that the elders in our country, spiritual elders in our country, this is where you can lend your voice and say, as a spiritual person, that you have because you have broken confidentiality, you have to do the honorable thing. Say something. Bishops, deacons, elders, all these people, where are you all? A woman actually break confidentiality and you all have nothing to say. But when I say it, hush your mouth, little boy, is a PNM. Well, I still see what I have to say. I speak in my truth. Hello, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon, Pastor Google.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to all the callers and listeners on 91.9 and Constructive Talk. That question you asked, as you already answered the second one, if they should take back the Silk, right? You can answer that. So I'll just stick on the first one, really. The law association is, as it says, an association. They have a constitution. The issue will be, what does the constitution say when a lawyer would behave and act like that? Because when I look at the role and function, unless there's some other area that they speak about, it just simply said the association sees as one of its main role and function and duty and responsibility to uphold the constitution and the rule of law. Thus, it is fully committed to doing so by participating in debates to foster the notion of supremacy of the constitution and the law as a whole, and by commenting on any situation concerning the constitution. The association seeks to achieve its goal in all times in a noble tradition of professional independence, integrity, and social responsibility. So while they may have individual opinions on what should be or should not be done with cannabis abuse with regards to our statements, as insulting and degrading as it is, as a body, do they have the authority to do anything other than just probably write her and say she should apologize? And if she doesn't, could they do anything else? Because based on what I'm reading here, I don't see the law association having that type of autonomy over her. As individual lawyers, as S.C. Khan would have done, he came out and spoke his opinion, and we agreed with the first part of the things that he was saying in terms of give back Silk and all that. But when it comes to discipline and her, based on what she said, does the law association have that authority? Because if they have it, then somebody could say, why have they not disciplined Ramdin, Ram Logan, and all the other lawyers who have done things in contravention to what is the noble profession that they are supposed to uphold, the law and all that. So that's just what I will say on that. But my personal opinion, she was never a senior counsel to me because I will say she did not get to the right way. And when I look at her biography and all that, I'm not seeing anything. When you look at senior counsel Martino or Israel Khan or any other SC, when you see their lineage and the academics and what they would have done, it's nothing compared to her. So I understood this SC. I didn't respect it. I didn't acknowledge it. So, yes, she should give back whatever it is she has. She doesn't deserve nothing.
Thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, I'm here.
Good afternoon, sir.
Right. Pastor Google, I agree with you. And Sister Jenny, you couldn't put it better. The lady, in advocating that a vote of confidence come down against the AG, right? So she was trying to bring a matter to a close, opened up another matter because she didn't like the way in which the voting ended up. It is the worst thing you could ever do when you're a jurist. You in a matter and the matter comes to a close, but you subject yourself to open litigation. That is the worst action of somebody who is in the legal profession. And the lady should do the right thing and just return it. But again, this is the same bunch of people who in drafting a contract, right, for police commissioner, failed to put a renewal clause in it. All of them. All of them need to turn in their certificate. That's about it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, you Pastor Google.
Hi, good afternoon.
Pastor Google, that lady deserves to give back that silk. And I want to give you some work to do. I know you do some good research. Under what criteria, what was used
when the... You see, that... Okay. Sorry. No, I thought you were going to ask me to look and see under what criteria she would have got silk.
Yeah, well, we know himself or to himself. And she doesn't deserve it. She don't have the qualification. She don't have that ilk to deserve silk. So she deserves to show she's supposed to get it back. And I want to know under what criteria was used when Dr. Rowley, as leader of the opposition, was put out of parliament. You see, they set a precedent, eh? The PP government set a precedent. Maybe we could look into that. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
You see, Israel Khan, after how many years? It's about 10 years now, he's talking around this esteemed name that she put to herself and the former attorney general under her administration. And because she take a lash at the group of men that they didn't pull it off. Because if you listen to your girl last night, she was right.
No, I didn't listen.
Her against Paul Bottom.
No, I didn't listen. After the way she behaved the last time, I good.
I doesn't go on the thing, but I stay keen, but I doesn't press to get the light off her on the time.
Yeah.
So, according to her, the girl prepared all the condiments, cut a bit of tomatoes and onions, because still her dead. The law association is controlled by them. And they would be able to pull the screw off on the attorney general. If I'm able to move the attorney general, then I am able to destabilize the government and bring down the administration so they could call an election before time so I could get back into office. If you listen to the attorney general at one time, oh, he called a meeting and a waste of time. You see, are you not putting me up to create another section 34? And the prime minister, they asked him a question, he said, I am a geologist. And he was right. That question he had to pose it to the so-called good lawyers that the lady have. So now she have a problem. Because the man who was her lawyer, who defended her all the time, come back to say to her, after how many years, 10 years, to tell us now, you know, she acquired that suspiciously.
Hmm.
So she hasn't worked for it. That's what he's telling us tonight. She hasn't put in the work for it. So she can't talk on behalf of us. So please return that. After 10 years, he now knows that what she did was immoral and wrong towards this profession. You understand? Because he kept some lash. So he hit back. But you know, I wait tonight is Monday night.
For well, him. Of course. I wait to hear her response.
But if it's one night I'm sitting down to speak, then it's tonight.
All right, brother.
But I want to see which one of them take the testicles out of the jar.
It started yesterday with the press conference with the member of parliament for Rodney Charles, you know. Rodney Charles started the discussion yesterday.
Yeah, but he's not lashing back at that fella.
Who? Israel Khan?
Yeah.
No, they will talk about Israel. You waiting to hear about her talk about Israel Khan? She will not, Ms. Bisasa is not going to respond to Israel Khan.
See, and that is where the media is failing us.
Because she is going to respond. She may respond to the law association, but she is not going to respond to Israel Khan. Forget it. If that's your waiting with your popcorn and juice to hear. No. None of them is going to respond to Israel.
Because on the dog report or the under the pavement report this morning, they didn't want to raise our conversation. So I call and I tell them, I see what they're going on. They're only talking about what?
But that's what
the government and what the government.
But that is what I'm saying to you.
I refuse themselves. But so I show it out to them.
But that's what I'm saying to you. If the ground report is saying nothing, would you feel Miss Pierce, I'm gonna say anything? I'm gonna take our next call there.
All right,
man. Thanks to your call. Boy, you waited to hear. Nah, sorry.
Good morning, Pastor Google. So you have two interesting topics this morning. On the end of the news brief with scrap iron dealers, we'll give you input and say good work. But you jump to conclusion that you sure that the union didn't have a part to play with that. Where you get that information from? Did you do your research? You know who the scrap iron dealers were saying no, and having conversation with leading up to that decision? You know any involvement with other groups, interest groups and other organization play within the scrap iron dealers? You have no idea that. You know anything about the drive? No, you now call in the scrap iron dealers. One of the membership to come on your program. Where were you before? Again. Where were you before? The information we try to bring to the general public on a daily basis is you know the union is not a part of playing it. But we're supposed to find out first before you condemn any union. And we're condemning the union. When the union was up in arms with this administration in 2010, leading up to the 2015 general election. Because hip, 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 and hooray. Now, the table turn. Well, you have a problem with that, Pastor Google. And the second topic, when the Prime Minister has indicated to the same association as his bottom feeders, who he was talking about, and what context he put that statement in. Locked on and listening, Pastor Google.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor Google.
How are you, sir?
How are you?
Good, man.
Pastor Google, to answer that fellow there just now, it's not a matter of where we do. It's a matter of is there still a market for the items?
But wait now. He wants to know where I was. You know much live broadcast I do with the scrap iron dealers? Just to tell you, he now come on the station. You know much live broadcast I went to and do with the scrap iron dealers? So you feel it's no I talking about scrap iron dealers? You out of your place. You know start to listen talk show what? You know much times I leave here, go on us, in Signature Hall, where the scrap iron dealers doing a live broadcast and bringing it live on this station? So what are you
Pastor
talking
Google,
about?
I can't keep a manhole cover unless I know where I'm getting it sell. So we're talking about
And that is the issue.
No, that
it
not
still
easy
continues.
For them.
It at Vancouver. Just this weekend going here. My point is this. It's something that has to be done. Let it be done today, not tomorrow. We could talk all we want. But the point is, it is still being stolen. People still losing their telephone lines because there's a market here. Cut out the market, nobody ain't thiefing. And you increase the penalties. Do you understand? Because some of my thief are saying, let me thief and wait. But I am simply saying, if you cut out the market, who you going to sell it to? You understand? And even though the association may be saying certain things today, people still thiefing lines, people still thiefing manhole covers and other items. There might be toes where people can't get water because they're going into these places where the pumps and people. Look at the generator this weekend. So were you telling me? Anyway, that is one story. Let me go to the next one. Pastor Google, who gives silk in this country? Who has point
you,
silk?
You tell me now. Tell me who.
Who are the people who say, listen, Pastor Google, I hereby accord you silk.
Who?
You are now senior counsel.
Who does that? Who does
that? Who are the people?
Who?
Hey, Pastor Google, I don't know. My point is this, Pastor. You see, the law association, and I want to know, according to Jewel Brown, the law association wants her to apologize. Who in the law association wrote to Kamala Prasad Bishop to ask her to apologize? Was it Sophia Cho, the president?
Hey.
I need to know. I want names. This thing about the law association, because as far as I am concerned, there is a UNC cabal in the law association. That is why she called names of, why did they call names of Taklal Singh? Why she called Miss Rambacham name? Huh? Why she called every sin in her name?
But, and remember, in all of this we're talking here, in all of this that we're talking here, don't forget, don't lose the key of all your brain and forget the threat by Wayne Mark, eh?
I hardly hearing you.
I said, don't forget. You hearing me good?
Yes.
Don't forget the threat by Wayne Mark. Remember, Wayne Mark said, once you attack our leader, you will not come out unscathed.
This is my point.
Uh-huh.
That's why I want names. Hello?
Yeah.
That is why I want names, Pastor. I ain't giving it no association. I know when Jewel Brown ready here, not to say he say, she say, this one say, that one say. I don't want the association. I want the same people we were seeing running to get the 40 names with the letter. You understand? To have to bring this these two issues against this attorney general. I want to know the names of the people. That is what I want to know too. The same way Kamala Prasad Bisesa want them to publicize my words, the names of those who voted so she could call it out on the podium.
Yeah, boy.
And I'm the least way to get it. I want the names of the people who give silk in this country and don't accord silk, and those people who wrote the letter to her asking her to apologize. I want to know the names. Is it Sophia Cho, the president? Yes or no? And that is my point.
Thank you.
You see, we could be asking for what we want to ask for, Pastor. But if I don't get names to go along with that, you ain't telling me nothing about that. You know, you come and tell me that, oh, the law association is not a political body. Really? But how come up to today, I haven't heard them ask for no voting or no voter, no confidence in certain people like Gerald Ramdin, like Varun Gevedin, like Anand Ram Logan. How come?
All right.
How come up to now, me and here, nobody asked for that? The same law association who writing her to ask for an apology. How come none of them ever write, have a forum to discuss these people having no confidence in these other people who have serious matters to answer before the court? You understand?
Yeah, man.
And that is my issue, that is my position. But if you're kind of attacking the Chief Justice, place and putting up signs all over the place that he must go. What did the law association say then? Eh? How come it was only Israel Khan doing that and certain other attorneys? You see, when it's on one foot, it's good. It's always the association saying the association. But when it's on the other foot, you don't see nobody.
Mm.
And that is my issue.
Yes.
I want names, Pastor. And I want to know who are called silk in this country. I need to know that. If somebody listening knows, call us and say. Because I have questions for that individual or that body too. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for calling. Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, good evening, Pastor.
Good afternoon.
I just want to commend Mr. Alan Ferguson and his association for the effort they're making to clean up this whole thing in the scrap iron industry.
Yeah.
That gentleman who called just now and talked about something about some union, and he knows that the whole of this thing, man.
Nah, them fellas and them feel I just come now. Them fellas and them think I just come and I just watching, in, I just playing a clip from on the news. That's what they feel. They feel there's the kind of talk show host I am. Just play something from on the news and I just ramble and talk about it and whatever. But he ain't listen to the construction of how I put together my statements. And he don't know that it's not now I know about the scrap iron dealers. And it's not now that they have been doing live broadcasts. And I am the one in this company that has go out and do live broadcast. So it's not no I know about scrap iron dealers.
Listen, Pastor Google, Mr. Ferguson had David Abdullah and Ozzy Warwick on that same program when it was broadcast on this same station.
Ah.
They announced a rally from San Fernando, never getting no permission.
And you remember that?
Must you remember that?
And I called the commissioner. I had called the commissioner live on radio and asked him if he gave them permission, and he said no. He also said to me that they were being misled by union.
Listen, let me finish and get somebody else understand. These is the same men done that match. They never had no permission and they had to scrap that match. And I was saying to myself, no, I am nothing against Abdullah and them, you know. I say to myself, you see this man they call Alan Ferguson, and I'm following that man for a while. You know why? Some of the other think that gentleman genuine.
Yeah, yeah.
And I am saying, I am happy that Mr. Stuart Young had the time to sit and talk with this
Thank
man.
You.
Listen, Mr. Ferguson, you see what you and your association doing? We need a lot more people to be doing that in training.
Ah, listen, and that is why I clapped him, sir. You see what you said there? You see what you said there, sir? It's one of the reasons why I applaud them. Because there are plenty of people who send in voice notes, who know to talk, but they don't have solutions. And they are looking and they are coming up with solutions to deal with the issue at hand.
And I am saying, you see, Mr. Ferguson, I don't know if you're listening. Hats off to you. You know why? I always wanted you to get an audience with the authorities. And I live to see Stuart Young and them sit down and talk to you. And you see what you're trying to do? I with you 100%. This whole stuff in the industry and this nonsense and all this copper teeth and all of it, it needs to streamline. And you know something? It's going to be better for everybody. Things is going to be done in order and everybody will be more comfortable. Mr. Ferguson, hats off to you and your organization.
Thank you very much. And that is my point. Hello, good afternoon. Hello, good afternoon.
Pastor Google.
Hi.
Sorry to call back in. But isn't the Law Association a democratic organization where people can vote yay or nay on an issue?
Yes.
Hey, Pastor Google?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Right. So, because this lady, opposition leader, is a wounded animal, didn't get her way. So she's ranting and raving because they had the plan. If they had gotten through with that, they know what they would have done. call all kind of thing and mayhem and confusion. But they didn't get their way. Like how with the bail bill, where a lot of the people in the parliament, I think they don't know one group, did not read the bill properly, and they got through with that. They figure that they're holding everybody. You know, they have everybody under lock. You see? So they're wounded, and they will continue to be wounded. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Going back to the lines.
Okay, Pastor Google. So where was the live when the union in the same signature hall had a live interview? How you didn't broadcast that one?
Because they must have didn't pay.
The wrong table was with the
because they must have didn't pay. You think we just do live broadcast just so?
I know listening to this radio station.
You know listening to this radio station.
So you say that man of silk. Right? So you saying that you're sure. What were you saying, you know? I want to quote you again. You sure that the union had no involvement? And I'm telling you, in Signature Hall, it had a live conference when the lunch you drive, where the round table had union members on it. You didn't see that live, Pastor Google? So again, your statement is contrary. Is what life you want to bring out to the general public?
Like you are something at me. Like they send you for me. You just listen to my program to try to send voice notes to try to do what? I don't know, like they send it to try to rile me up. But they don't know that I have people like Mother Dolly and them praying for me. I have a 96-year-old lady praying for me, you know. So that your voice note wouldn't irritate me or wouldn't have me in a disarray. I'm not even talking that. So you trying to derail me from my discussion and my topic and the real essence of what I said about the scrap iron dealers. So let me repeat it for you if you didn't hear it. And I'm glad that the caller before you would have highlighted it. My real issue or my real discussion about the scrap iron dealers, sir, if you're trying to derail or twist my discussion to the unions, I don't care. About the unions, brother. Right? I just feel Miss Dolly praying for me today, so I had to tone it down a little bit. I don't really care about the scrap iron, about the unions, you know. Right? Because the unions wasn't sitting there when they did their presentation on how they are structuring or restructuring the Scrap Iron Dealers Association. The unions wasn't there, sitting there with them. They were sitting there presenting their structure of how they tend to go forward. And my discussion today on Street 919 FM is that I tip my hat off to them, scrap iron dealers, for coming up with a plan to deal with an issue that is happening in our country. That is my discussion, sir. Not you and your union, and you calling to defend your union. I am saying publicly, right, that I tip my hat off to the scrap iron dealers for coming up with a solution to help and to deal with the stealing of iron, that is my What I want to highlight. I came to highlight that. You want to highlight union, that is your business. If you want to highlight union, you could come and buy time like other persons and talk your union talk. I am happy to sit here and highlight the union, the scrap iron dealers and their fantastic way of seeing a problem, identifying the problem in the industry and coming up with a solution for it.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
When you say no zombie, I must just say, okay, back. I'm a zombie. Pastor Google, you want to know how common I get sell?
I don't want to know. I don't want to know from you. I don't. Thank you. Afraid you. No, I don't want to know from you. Thanks, but no thanks. I want to keep my little $2, please. Hello, good afternoon. Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, good afternoon.
Hey, how are you going?
I'm good.
Right, talk to me.
First of all, the opposition leader will not apologize.
But we know that.
To the law association.
Yeah, we know that. For
He's
sure.
He's not going to apologize to anybody.
Yeah.
I agree with our caller before who said that she's a wounded animal. And but you see, there are two things I just want to say. I want to take up time. One, what I would like her to do, since she wants name, I want her to call the name of the Indo-Trinidad Senior Council who she felt voted in favor of Armour. There are quite a few, eh? You have Ramesh Lawrence Maraj, you have Deborah Peak, you have Hendrix Suna from South, you have Avery Sinanam. You know, call those names. Don't only call Martineau and Elton Prescott and those fellas. Call the names, and Israel Khan, call the names of the Indo Trinidad lawyers who are senior counsel. Why are you afraid to call their names? Some of them, it looks as if most of them voted in favor of Amo. So you would have a beef with them too. Why are you not calling on them to take their position? Why only call the names of the two or three African lawyers, senior counsel? Why? And secondly, finally, how come you wanted to know about the names of people, names of the lawyers who voted in favor of getting rid of Ivor Archie 2 years ago? How come? They are sacrosanct then. They are specially appointed lawyers then. But if she knows why, that whole thing with Archie was an Indo-Trinidad lawyer business, eh? Just like the business with Amo. Because you know Trinidad, you understand the culture of this country. If Amo was with the UNC and he had done the same thing as Attorney General, he would have defended him from here to that kingdom come. He would have done no wrong. So forget about the hypocrisy and the nonsense of those people. Okay, good afternoon.
Thank you very much.
Pastor Google, good afternoon. That last voice note, he is a Johnny Comblety, or he being paid by the opposition to come and disrupt your program, because I could distinctively recall you had already broken down or went into detail about the Scrap Iron Dealers Association. So that voice note, he is a paid fanatic to come and disrupt your program. But I just wanted to stay focused, Pastor Google, and let he ratty really dirty linens and a dirty mouth, pampas mouth. Right? The comment and talk as that BS in people's head. Get your facts right before you come on the radio. Google on radio, not now. Google on radio, long time. And the man, as we all know him, does go and do his research before he come and bring facts to the public. He don't know, yeah, say no, say them, say she, say who, say. Is a man that's go and do his research and come on the radio and bring the facts to the people. Unlike those other talk show program like the Under Pavement Report on the cooking station on Traffic Road. Better you go and listen to that Gubar on that radio station. I don't come here to rhetoric and FBS. Google Pastor Google Dr. Tone.
Alright, Eric. All right, so this is the time where I take first-time callers. First-time callers only, but I see I have some voice notes here that I have to play because they were there before. So let me play these voice notes.
Hey, Pastor Google, that fella was dreaming. He just said, come on, let him. He was in that 7 days weekend. You understand? He wasn't there all the time when you were talking about the scrapping. I tired see you come up and bringing up these things. But we're going on tea. He want the fellas in to continue thiefing and bring it in to sell. So how the country in that kind of nasty way, that's big hole empty and the great king people place and thiefing down and said, that is what he like. So he doesn't need talking again and talk. Remember, other than cut you off when you come back home, we don't hear him. He's the imps, pimps, and chimps.
Good afternoon, Aisha. Nice one. Pastor Google have was nothing on a dieted PRM, you know. He's seen it all it is and he talking. Don't vex with him at all, Pastor Google. You continue doing your work for the PRM, my man. Great is the PRM and wickedness increasing more and more.
You different, you know, boy. You different, boy. Hey, Mr. Bigo, I see your voice note. I'll play all these voice notes for you.
Good morning. The Law Association is filled with hypocrites. They claim they are not a political organization, yet they politically pontificate on many political issues on convenient occasions. The purpose of the Law Association is to create rules and regulations for its legal membership. That is all. They are not part of the constitutional hierarchy. The Law Association is not enshrined within the Constitution of Trinidad and Tobago. Because just as they can pontificate on the removal of this Attorney General because of so-called Miami issue, which has been pontificated by the UNC on many occasions on all levels, social media and mainstream media, how come they never pontificated on the previous Attorney General who is previously before the court and they still have yet to do so? So the fact that they claim that they are not a political institution, yet putting themselves into political arena conveniently, says a lot about their level of hypocrisy in their hierarchy. And many people seem to be congratulating Israel SC for his pontifications on Kamala SC, another hypocrite. Because they make all this explanation about why she is not qualified and why she should not be SC and everything within the ambit of what he believes is a hypocritical statement she made on her political platform. Yet at the end of his whole tirade, he stated, I will still support you and I will still vote for you. Blatant hypocrisy. What does that tell you all? The president of the Scrap Iron Dealers Association has a long road to travel. An unfortunate long road. I applaud his efforts, but I also sympathize with him because he has made himself become a political pawn in the political arena by certain people. I hope he comes to his senses at some point in time. He must continue his fight. I agree with his fight. Because the scrap iron dealers have become criminally inclined. But unfortunately, there's a lot of criminal elements within the Scrap Iron Dealers Association. Question is, how many of these people are registered scrap iron dealers?
Well, I think that's what they're trying to do, register
them. This is part of the long fight he has. Because in Trinidad and Tobago, we know doing the right thing is not something a lot of people have compassion to do. Because it's easier to do the wrong thing and hope they get away with it. Because many seem to be getting away with it. So they continue along their lines of illegality. And I've heard him made a statement on many occasions that he would rather die than see the Scrap Iron Dealers Association fall. He needs to be careful on the words he chooses at times. Because of the criminal elements within that industry he feels so passionately about. I hope he protects himself well. I hope he continues his fight, but he must fight based on the issue of wanting to build and better the industry and not become politically inclined. and allow others to bring down the industry that he is passionate about. Again, my opinion.
All right, so I can't take any more voice notes. And I really wanted to take some first-time callers, but I see my time is counting down. So I'll have to do that tomorrow. Please go on. So again, I want to thank, and I'm glad that the callers and listeners understood the position that I was taking where the scrap iron dealers are concerned.
Yeah, Google, good afternoon. Me don't want to hear the Law Association and Uncle when there was the Kamala and them was behind the Chief Justice and all perceived PNM lawyers, they wasn't saying anything. So it's only because she trained she guns on all of them on the association, they get her voice now. So let them take bamboo. Me don't want to hear them at all. I wish tonight on she meeting, she jump be them and say all kind of thing about them again too. So let them take that.
Oh gosh.
Pastor Google, I have no confidence in that woman. None what at all. She needs to give back the silk cotton that she gives herself. The silk cotton. She needs to give it back. She's not worthy of that. And Pastor Google, the Law Association, they are speaking out too late. And they're not fooling it because they have two men who are before the court and they have done nothing with them, that they are still practicing law in this country. So when they get rid of them, then I could say that I have confidence in the Law Association also.
So
Pastor Google, according to the boy who always calling and harassing Aisha, she got to go.
All right, well, I'm out of here, Trinidad and Tobago. I want to thank all of you for your voice notes and your contributions. Sorry, first-time callers. I know today's topic was really hot, but all my first-time callers, we're going to make sure and introduce this segment properly so that I can get you all in the program on the Street 99 FM. I'm out of here. I want to thank again all my viewers on Facebook and on YouTube for giving me the opportunity to be in your homes, in your office, and on your cell phones, and wherever you are in the world that you're looking at me. Thank you very much. Talk to you guys tomorrow, please God. All right? I had a great time today hearing from you guys.
Expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
So tonight we're celebrating. We don't break down some barriers. We don't mash up some walls. We don't put the devil in the place. So we're going to celebrate. Hey! Say, remember, remember. Remember my name.